Good morning, my lawn and garden friends. Welcome back to Mow Time. In today's video, we are fixing up a turf job that was done by a client here. They had a go at fixing a section of lawn that had died off due to lawn grub, but unfortunately they had ordered the wrong turf. So they've now got me in to rectify the situation. I've removed the old turf that was there. And now it's just a bare dirt patch, and I've ordered the turf and it's come in today. So yeah, we're going to fix this dirt patch up, probably stop and give a few pointers on the way. But yeah, this will just be basically showing you how to repair an area and put new turf or sod for you guys in America down in this area. So yeah, of course, if you have any questions in regards to laying turf or renovations or you know, anything whatsoever, put it in the comments below and I'll be more than happy to get back to you and help you out on that. So yeah, anyway, I hope everyone's had a great start to their 2022. Let's make this a good year. We've got another beautiful day here in Brisbane, Queensland, Australia. So yeah, thanks for joining us on today's little video. Make sure you hit that subscribe button to keep up with heaps of videos to come in 2022, both educational. I've got a bunch of reviews I'm doing at the moment on different garden tool products and have a heap of reviews coming to the channel as well. So yeah, make sure you're subscribed for that. I really do appreciate the support from you guys on the channel. So yeah, anyway, excited to get into this. Let's get this property fixed up for the client, make them very happy, and then move on to the next job.
So this is the spot behind me that we're going to be fixing up. Now I'm getting a bit closer so you can actually see it. So yeah, this is the bare spot behind me. Not too big, but yeah, definitely a spot that needs fixing up. So, Sir Walter here already. So obviously we'll be matching with that. We're not going to change our grass variety. We're going to go ahead and make sure it matches with what is already down here. So yeah, let's make a start on this. We'll get the soil level and then we can start laying the turf down. All right, there you go. So I've just put down some turf pieces and now we know we need to cut out to here, where it will join the existing grass. So yeah, super easy to just do it like that. I'll just mention too, now you see me digging out some existing Sir Walter buffalo. And just keep in mind, when you do remove some of those areas, don't always necessarily need to throw them away. Just see if you can utilize the stolons to plant elsewhere where you might have, you know, a smaller area that needs a bit of fill-in. So you could always plant this runner or stolon and it'll bed in and take off as long as you keep it watered and make sure the actual roots are getting make sure the roots are getting contact with the soil bed, then you can plant this and it'll shoot off somewhere else. So yeah, just bear that in mind when you're digging out little spare bits. Go blower. I'm currently in the middle of doing a review on this. I've had this for a couple of weeks now and been putting it through test runs every day in the ute and using it every day. But anyway, review will be already up or is coming to the channel. So if you're interested in Ego gear, make sure you keep an eye out for this review, or if it's already up, go and click on it and you'll be able to see my review on what I think of the Ego blower. Alright, so I'll just show you the low section. So this area has a sink like this here, and where you just saw me scrape this out, this is the more raised area. So this is where the water pools more. When it rains, etc., it all comes to this corner, so it's just sunk a bit more there. So I've just scraped the top off here, just because this needed some leveling as well. The turf that was here, you know, it left a lot of its soil behind, so it was a bit of a arch there. So yeah, need to get that nice and level, and don't rush this. If you're new to renovating, just take your time and keep checking it and that. So yeah, and then make sure you remove any debris that you don't want under your soil, turf, sorry, such as rocks, concrete, anything like that. Make sure you get rid of that as well. So yeah, I've got a bit of fresh soil, fresh underlay, we call it here in Australia. Underlay, or I don't know what you're, yeah, I just call it underlay, but just means under the turf, underlay soil. So I'll bring in some of that because this is still a bit of a gully there. So we'll level this area and then we'll go through with my screed. Well, it's not a screed, it's literally just a piece of straight timber, but that's all you need, as long as you've got something that's nice and straight that you can drag across the soil, just to make sure your levels are right, and it'll show you where any dips are that need to be filled in. So yeah, let's get stuck into that. All I wanna be, I knew you'd be back. All right, guys, so normally I'm not gonna roll this because I haven't put down a very deep level of soil. If you are putting like more than, you know, 20 mil or more of soil down, sometimes, you know, your base is like 150 to 100 mils of underlay, you definitely need to roll it. But given I'm only just putting a light spread over this, I'm not gonna bother rolling it. It doesn't need it. So yeah, so that's it. So yeah, make sure you roll. Now with the screeding, that's really important step. One, obviously, to level out before you put your soil down, but also it just makes you go through it, get closer to the soil, pick out anything, you know, in there that you don't want to be there, any weeds you might have missed or any rocks, etc. So it's a good chance to go through, like you might have seen me do, and pull out things that you don't want there. So yeah, so this is nice and level now. Now, a common question that is talked about is whether you need to put down a starter fertilizer. Now, in all the years I've been doing it, I've never used starter fertilizers. I don't think you need to, especially with Sir Walter. Sir Walter's a really hardy grass variety, and it takes off, especially now in Australia, we're in growing season and there's plenty of rain around, etc. So yeah, I personally have never used starter fertilizer. I don't think it's needed. If you've got some good soil to bed on, some good fertilized, lots of nutrients soil, and you keep the water up with it, then you don't need a starter fertilizer. If you want to put down something, you know, just to scratch that itch in your head, then put something down, like a liquid feed of sea sole or Charlie Carp or Seaweed Secrets or something like that. Just anything with a kelp base in it, just to give the roots a boost along in bedding in to their new home. So yeah, that's all I recommend and that's all I do. No fertilizer spread out now, just a good feed of a kelp product to help the roots kick along. So yeah, keep that in mind. But again, it's up to you. If you want to put a starter fertilizer down, by all means do so. It's not gonna hurt. So long as you use a starter fertilizer, don't use another you know, maintenance style fertilizer. It's not the appropriate form of ratio of nutrients for new turf. You can end up ruining and burning your turf off and killing it. So don't just use any fertilizer. Make sure the packet says starter fertilizer for new turf. Okay, all right, let's get some turf down. You'll see I'm able to pick up the turf and then just place it down exactly ready to go. So that's a little pro tip. When you're picking up your turf out of the wheelbarrow, whether it's on the ground or off the pallet or wherever you're getting it, pick it up so you're ready to able to just place it straight down. Because turf, to a lot of people, isn't light. And when you're doing hundreds of square meters, it's a big arm workout. So make sure by, you know, picking up the turf correctly already, so you can just walk straight over and place it straight down and unfold it, just is way less strain on your body and it saves you moving around your turf, because the more you handle turf, the more it's prone to break apart, which just is a nightmare when you're trying to make sure all your pieces butt together and you just don't end up destroying your piece of turf that you paid for. So yeah, little pro tip there, make sure you pick it up correctly to the position you're going to place it in. That way it'll save you heaps of energy and time. Alright guys, I'll just show you another tip as well. So once you put your turf down, you've got to make sure that it is getting good turf to soil contact. And what that means is basically the base of your turf piece is directly contacting with your soil bed. And that's why it's important to roll or just like stamp over it like this, to make sure you're pushing the turf down onto your underlayer of soil. The other important thing is to go through and make sure your actual joins are not lipping like on top of each other like that. So what, by fixing that up, just grab your pieces like this and do that.
make sure they're not, you know, one's sitting on top of the other like that.
That means there's no sort of contact on this piece here and it'll die off.
So yeah, by picking them up like this, placing them down,
that way you know at your joins they're all completely touching the soil and your joins will grow in nicely. Guys, the other tip you'll see me doing here is it might look weird that I'm staggering the turf pieces, but that is for good reason. It just helps with growing in. So what you generally want to do is do, just like you were mowing, do a border pass. So lacing around the border, and then you start to interlock them like so. You'll see what I'm doing. You don't just, like you saw the two I put down here first, you don't just do another two and another two and another two so all the joins are in a row. You don't ideally want that. Again, like I said, if you ended up with a heap of joins all in a line for however long meters, and it just doesn't allow the turf to grow in, because generally if you're going to have some turf not go well, it generally will be the corners that aren't getting the best contact, or the edges, especially the ends, to the best contact to the soil. So that's why you don't just lay them out in all the same pattern all the way through your turf area. Make sure you zigzag them, but again, like I said, do your border pass first and then start to make your way through from one end to the other. And that's it. But yeah. In the lawn, digging any dirt, or also for turf cutting, because I've got a straight one, way easier, and you need to have a really sharp tool for cutting your turf. That's really important. You can buy specific turf cutting tools, but I've just always used my shovel. As long as it's nice and sharp, then it'll just slice through like butter and create a clean cut through the plant or through the turf. So yeah, make sure you've got a sharp shovel. Guys, so the turf, hang on, let's turn the radio down. All right, so the turf is in, as you can see behind me. Now, I left this gap as well. If you end up with a big gap like this, you know, and say you've run out of turf, you've got no more turf,
and you're not going to go back and buy another piece of turf just for, you know, a 2-inch gap, 3-inch gap, whatever. No dramas, just throw some fresh soil in there. Sir Walter grows so fast, and once it's had a some kelp feed, liquid feed on it, this will just take off and that'll be grown over in like a couple of weeks, no dramas at all. So yeah, so I'll just talk about the rest of the lawn as well. So with the rest of the lawn here behind me, I'm just stopping here with the turf because we are going to be renovating this section of lawn because it is fine. So yeah, so this next section will be for another video. Let me know in the comments below if you do want me to shoot the renovation on the remaining turf here. But yeah, this one, you can just sort of see in the soil profile, once you've been working around soil for a while, you can tell when soil is really deficient in nutrients just by looking at it, feeling it, all that sort of stuff. You just get to know with that. So yeah, this really needs a top dress with some new soil. And I say soil, not sand, because just remember, sand has like zero nutrients in it. It has a lot of beneficial factors, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't have any actual nutrients in it. And grass and plants, being a living cell, require food like us to continue to thrive and be healthy. So we're going to use soil when we do the top dressing on this also. Yeah, so let's finish up with these little gaps. Like I said, just fill them in with some soil or some sand. You can use sand if you're just filling in little gaps like that and that's all you got. Just fill them in with that. Fill them in with something. Don't just leave them empty. And then it's the watering process and we're done. All right, let's get into it. Alright guys, so we are finished up here. The turf is now down and we're just watering it in. Now, rule of thumb for watering in turf is just don't let it dry out. So we're having 28 to 30 degree days here in Brisbane at the moment, but as you can see above me, a whole bunch of leopard trees that are providing a lot of shade to this area of lawn. So it isn't copping direct sunlight the whole time. So if it was, then obviously you need to up your watering because it will be drying out a lot faster. But given that this is in the shade, I'd only recommend watering, a good soak in the morning and a good soak in the afternoon as well. If, again, it was direct sunlight, you'd be doing a soak in during the day as well, just to make sure the moisture is staying in the plant. So, so that's it. So I'll let the client know when to turn this off so they get an idea. And just give them a bit of information in regards to ongoing watering process because I'll be leaving here because we are done. Now, the garden I already did, so I come through and renovated this garden. It had nothing in it and it had two other big trees just here in this gap here. I chopped them down. They were the same as this fella behind me here. I removed them just because the amount of leaves that come down from a leopard, if you have a leopard tree, etc., then you'll know they drop a lot of leaves, a lot of sticks, a lot of the seed pods. But anyway, the main reason why we removed these two big trees here was because to allow more sunlight to come through to this area. This area over here was very, very shaded, like too shaded for Sir Walter, and it just wasn't, no grass was growing there in the past, as the client had said, which is not surprising given it gets, you know, no sun whatsoever. So we removed those trees. That allowed a lot more light to come through in the morning. The sun sets over this direction here in Brisbane. A lot more sun coming through there, sorry. We're going to be finished up here. Now, I'm sorry I didn't shoot the renovation for this garden video. I was extremely busy with work, and given that I'm a newbie to all this filming and still not great at it, it takes a long time for me to film a video at a job. You don't just get in and do the job and get out. There's obviously a lot more to it than that. So I just unfortunately didn't have time to do this garden renovation for a video for you guys. So apologies for that. But anyway, there it is now, filled in.
And looks a lot better when it did. I think I have a photo of it, how it originally looks. So I'll put that up on the screen now and you can see the difference. But we wanted to get the garden done first. So yeah, if you're ever doing renovations on your property with garden and lawn, make sure you're working in a correct order so you're not walking back over your work. So I wouldn't have renovated this section of the lawn first and then re-turfed that section and then done the garden, because then I'd just be walking over my new lawn that I just laid and renovated to get to the garden. So make sure you work from the furthest point back towards your point of entry with your supplies of materials of soil, mulch, turf, etc., so you're not walking back over what you've just fixed up. So hence that's why we did garden first. Now we did the new turf in this section and we're working back towards over that way, which is the driveway access. So now we do the lawn renovation and we won't be walking over our beautiful work we've put in. So yeah, anyway guys, I hope you're having a fantastic start to 2022. Like I said, hope you're starting to kick those goals, you know, that you make. If you do make goals, hope you're ticking them off. My goal is to spend more time on the channel this year and get my merchandise up and going, which I am currently working on still. So sorry, you have to be patient with me with that one. I'm just sort of going through suppliers and deciding, because I don't want to bring sort of cheap quality products. That's not what my it's not what I'm all about. It's not what my business is all about. I bring good quality stuff regardless of what it is. So I just trying to find good quality products for you guys to sell as Mowtime merchandise. So keep an eye out for that. I'll keep you guys updated. But anyway, hope you're staying well mentally and physically as always, guys, and we'll see you legends in the next video.